It is an honour for me to have been invited to attend the service of remembrance as a representative of Her Majesty the Queen and as British Consul General here in San Francisco. Thank you all for joining us today to commemorate the valiant work of those who have served in our armed forces and pay tribute to the men and women whose sacrifices laid the foundation of society as we know it today, one of liberty and abundant freedoms. I want to thank those who have been so involved in putting together the service today, particularly those at Grace Cathedral, the bands and honour guards, the St Andrew's Society, the Royal Canadian Legion, the Royal British Legion, and of course the team from the British Benevolent Society. Ladies and gentlemen, we come here, of course, to pay our respects to the fallen, the wounded, and all whose lives have been and are affected by conflict. They are the ones who have given so much for the freedoms that we enjoy today. For the loved ones who mourn their loss, this act of remembrance does not, of course, only happen once a year. But there is an added element of honouring their sacrifice when we come together on this day. Because we do so as part of a bigger community, as all around the world we gather together, at war graves, by cenotaphs, in town squares, and on village greens. It's an occasion when we step out of our busy, hectic lives, when we pause from enjoying and experiencing the liberty and opportunities that were won and defended for us at such a cost, in order to say, quite simply, thank you, as well as we will remember you. Although we remember those from all conflicts, 2017 marks the 100th anniversary of some of the worst battles of the World War I, including the tens of thousands of lives that were lost in the battles of Arras and Passchendaele in order to bring peace to Europe. Those soldiers didn't go to war because they loved fighting. They were ordinary people who responded in extraordinary ways in extreme times. Some of the horrors that they witnessed, whether the horrific casualty rates in both the Eastern and Western fronts, or the murderous stalemate of the trenches, are barely comprehensible to us 100 years later. But comprehend it we must, and remember it we will. Because only by doing so do we truly honour their sacrifice. Today, we have brave women and men who continue to go into the battlefield to protect our freedoms across many parts of the globe. We thank them for their courage and their resilience. In closing, I would like to offer my most sincere thanks to the veterans and the congregation and their families. I would also like to thank those who took time out of their day to pay tribute to this community. And I would finally like to thank those who organised today's events. It is you who helped keep these memories alive.